Hey everybody, Christina with One Creative Direction. I am back. This will be my second video for today, and I am doing a lot of firsts today. So my previous video, if you didn't catch it, I just did a bloom with a new recipe and I tried out some of the unicorn spit on a bloom, which turned out very cool. You'll have to check out the video I just did earlier today. If you can't find it, let me know. I will send you a link or link it in the description if I remember. It's been a long weekend. So I thought since I got everything set up, like I said in my previous video, I had this puppy pool for a while, maybe a couple weeks, and somebody gave me a table to put it on. So I spent most of the weekend trying to get everything set up. Moved my furniture around so I had enough space, because previously I was doing all of my artwork on my kitchen table, and it was a very high table, and I was like reaching up over everything and trying to reach down, and sometimes on the step stool, just not safe. So a little bit better setup, definitely a lot more room. I did also pick up this really cool thing at Michael's. I know a lot of people are buying cake turners. I found this at Michael's, and of course they had their, I had 25% off in my coupons, but this was only like $8 or $9. I thought I would use this for my tiles, and then my bigger turntable for my bigger blooms, like the 15-inch circle that I just did earlier. So I have some paint left over, so I'm gonna do some tiles. For those of you, I know there's been a lot of people commenting lately about how do I get started on tiles. A lot of people talking about various things. I do have quite a few videos on my YouTube, so if you wanna go to my YouTube channel, like and subscribe, and check out all those videos that I have on doing tiles and painting and sealing and putting the cork on the back and all kinds of things. Actually, I have a few more planned here in the next week. I got some prep work done for that. So as far as before you paint, I usually just wipe them off with either a wipe or a paper towel and some alcohol spritzed on it. Either way, I've also just kind of wiped my hand over to make sure there's no dust. Honestly, the paint sticks with no issue. I am gonna try this first one. I'm thinking in my mind it's probably not gonna work, but I'm gonna try it anyway. I don't think this paint is thick enough to stick to the tile and stay, but this is the pillow slash base that I used on the bloom that I just finished. And it wasn't necessarily like a house paint for strictly the pillow. I mixed my bloom mixture with 50-50 with a white metallic gloss paint that I had gotten on clearance at Michael's by Art Minds. I have just a little bit left here and I want to use it, and I thought I would do a real quick tile. And then once I'm done with this, hopefully the video won't be too long. Once I'm done with this one, oh, I might have enough for two if this one works out. I have some other tiles that I want to do. I bought some onyx black. All the tiles that I've done so far have been on white base, and I have a few that I want to do on a black base. So I'm gonna try that out today. I've got that ready off camera. Switch to that when I'm done experimenting with this pillow paint for my other bloom. Pop those bubbles there. All right, and I'm gonna do some really unusual colors, colors that I don't necessarily care for. But I do have people in my life that I think would really, really like it if this works out. This is Burnt Sienna, I believe. Yes, by Master's Touch. I've never used this color before, but I do know somebody who likes these warm tones. So I'm gonna use a few different colors in this that I wouldn't normally use for myself. This one is, I believe, Artist Loft Emerald Green. See how well these colors play together. Like I said, These are probably some of my least favorite colors, but someone very special to me loves these colors. And I am going to put, I ran out of spoons. I'm gonna put a little bit of this yellow in here. This is Artist Loft Brilliant Yellow. I'm not really sure if I've ever, yeah, I think I have used this color. Stick that in there. All right. And this is a first time for this one as well. This is actually, wait for it. I don't know if anybody's ever bought it. They have a Crafter's Square paint at the Dollar Tree. And I've always wanted to just kind of try it to see if it's a, you know, a thumbs up or a thumbs down. But it just so happens it's the only orange that I had, and this is probably one of her favorite colors. Oops. I'm gonna stick some orange in the center. And debating on if I put just a teeny bit of gold in here. I think I might do that. This is Deco Art 24 karat gold. Everyone's favorite. I'm just gonna put a tad on there. We all know what happens when you put gold in there. Okay, and my cell activator is just Amsterdam White. I probably put a, probably close to a 3:4:1 ratio to flood. That's all that's in here. I have nothing else in here. There's no pre-stain in here, nothing else. It's straight flood American and Amsterdam White paint. And when I do cell activators, I usually like to put a little bit of white before I put the black on. I feel like sometimes it just disperses better and looks nicer. And then my black cell activator is straight golden carbon black in flood. So I did mix my bloom colors a little bit different than some of my other tiles that I did, and that I used triple thick poly instead of the regular Minwax gloss poly. I saw a video where somebody had done that with their mixture, and I wanted to try it out, and it turned out really beautiful on my last one. So sticking with that mixture. So I am going to pop a few of these bubbles real quick. This pillow paint had a lot of bubbles. Alright, so a lot of firsts for me today. First time using this table, the puppy pool, the cake spinner, and some of these colors. Nice cells. So while that sits there, wanted to tell you about a new YouTube channel that I'm going to be starting in the next, I'm going to guess, 3 to 4 weeks when weather starts getting better here in Ohio. I'm an avid kayaker. Art's just kind of a hobby that I used to do when I was much younger, and I recently kind of got an interest in it again. So I saw all these poor videos and just really kind of instilled this newfound love for art. I think I'm gonna wreck this a little bit. And I'm gonna start a YouTube channel for my adventures in kayaking. A bit of a adrenaline junkie, and I do some pretty cool kayaking, not just in Ohio. I do travel to other states, have a couple of those trips planned this summer. I'll upload all my videos from the last year or two. Pretty cool places that I kayak. Lots of really good friends that I kayak with. Actually went to Florida last fall sorry, I'm going to talk your ear off while I'm waiting on this. Went to Florida last fall and kayaked some of the most beautiful rivers I have ever seen in my life. Kayaked by some alligators, just kind of hanging out on the edge of the river. But yeah, I'll post all of those. So if anybody has an interest in anything like that, please watch for that. And I, of course, will mention it on this channel when I get that up and running. But as always, I would really, really appreciate any support. If you would go like and subscribe to my channel. I am trying to get enough followers to be able to do lives. So I know YouTube restricts you if you don't have, I think it's 1,200 subscribers, you can't do live video. So I am really trying to build my audience. So, and I have a lot of videos planned, so please stay tuned. So we're gonna give this a spin and see what happens. Hopefully those cells keep on forming. All right, we're gonna spin it the other way. Ooh, that is really pretty. I don't know, I'll bring you guys down closer once I get this all spun out. I'm not liking how this is not spinning very well. All right, let's try it again. That is so pretty. I don't know that I'm so thrilled about that black in the center, but man, the rest of those cells are really, really pretty. I wonder if there's a way that I can blow out those cells in the center with my straw. I don't want to ruin it, but let's go for it. Spin it one more time, maybe twice, who knows. All right, well that didn't help much, but those colors are super pretty. I think I put too much cell activator on it, probably the issue. All right, I'm gonna get this off of here, make sure all my corners are covered. These colors are right up her alley and she will really, really like these. Let's see if I can get this up. I don't know if you guys have ever dropped one of these, but I had this really, really pretty pink one day and I was so busy oohing and aahing over it, I dropped it on, right on its front. Totally ruined it. I called it a night because I was like, I am done. This off the bottom. I'm gonna do one more since I have enough of this paint left that I can do one more. I'm gonna take this over here. I also have another tip for all the new people that are doing tiles. I'll show that tip at the end of the video here before I sign off. For all you newbies that want to start making tiles, I have a few things to kind of maybe help you. Okay, so what I usually do is I usually take this paint and just scrape it off so it's not all gooey up there. Alright, grab another tile, do it again. I'm gonna go with the same color scheme because maybe the other one will turn out really nice and we'll have a set to give her. Should be plenty in here to do that. Oh yeah, there's plenty. I did find that this was a bit thinner, obviously, then like the Color Place paint that I usually use for my base on there, on these. I don't know if that's part of the reason why, like, most of my design disappears off the page and I'm left with cell activator in the center. But I'm going to Let's try, make sure I follow the same colors. That burnt sienna. I'll try to make a bigger circle in the center. Maybe that'll help. Okay. And then we did green, I think. This is the emerald green. Reminds me of St. Patty's Day coming up here. I don't know how many people are going to be out celebrating. I'm not much of a drinker. Like I mentioned on my last video, I just lost like 50 pounds. I'm still trying to lose 30 more. So alcohol is just not on the diet plan. Went out to celebrate my birthday and my brother from another mother's birthday last night, and they were all drinking and I was the designated driver. Says I cannot have any alcohol. I'm on a, I don't necessarily call it a diet, but I guess a diet plan with a fairly new company. They give you a plan, and it basically, between their food and the food that you prepare, it puts your body in ketosis. And after struggling with my weight for so many years, I'm feeling horrible. I feel like a million bucks. Like I'm 20 years younger. So really enjoying that. So I think I put a little bit of gold in there if I remember right. I don't know that I remember seeing it in the result, but okay. Maybe I shouldn't put as much cell activator in this time. All right, we're just gonna put a little bit this time then. There's that. Again. Okay, slow down. There we go. All right, fingers crossed it works better. Here we go. Cells that are forming are really pretty without the cell activator, it seemed like, but I don't know. Like I need to blow on that some more. All right, I'll leave it go. I'm done. I can't do it anymore. Hate the waiting. So the next tiles I'm going to do are going to be on Onyx Black base, the Color Place by from Walmart. I've not used that as a base. All the tiles that I've done to this point have been on a white base. So that'll be really, really interesting. I have some cool color combinations. Hopefully it'll look nice on it. Let's give it a spin. And again, that black is just overtaking the entire center. I'm not liking it. I'm not liking that that's not turning very well either. I think I might want to do this. There we go. Look too bad. I don't know if you guys can see that. the camera here. You can see that. It's not so bad. Without all the black in there, I think it would have been better, but if I could slide some of this around a little bit to make it look better. Get some of that black out of there. Slide some of this off of here. Hopefully, if you're new to these tiles, hopefully this video is helpful. You have to forgive me, I'm an engineer, so I always try to like MacGyver every process into, you know, how can I make that easier and more efficient? Always want to make sure your corners are covered. Sometimes those don't always get paint on them. What I usually do is try to get some of the paint off of here that matches. Just kind of stick it on the corner there. So you got coverage everywhere. I think everything else is good. All right, I'm going to take this over here and come back and we'll do an onyx black one. Tile. Okay, here goes nothing. Okay. Obviously a lot thicker than that pillow paint I was just working with. Okay, now the colors that I have in mind are hopefully just going to pop on here. And I want to try some of these bright unicorn spit ones on here. So we're going to put this pink one first. This is the, I can't remember the name of it now. Something Sterling Sasha. It's the metallic unicorn spit. And this is the sapphire swift. And it is also a metallic unicorn spit. I'm going to put those two. And I'm going to, I think, put these non-metallic unicorn spit in the center. Maybe just do those three colors. See how that works out. With a tiny touch of gold in the center. Okay. All right. Here goes the cell activator. Bit on each. Okay, let's do the black. All right. Hopefully between the black pillow paint and the black cell activator, we don't make a mess. I don't know that anybody's used these black onyx for tiles. Maybe there's a reason I haven't seen anybody do that. This might be the reason. I guess we're gonna find out. Here we go. I got a halo in the center, so that's a good sign. guess one of the tips that I would give some of the people that are just starting out for the tiles is a mistake that I learned when I first started practicing blooms on tiles. They say, practice on tiles. And I got so hooked on it, I literally just did my first bloom like 2 weeks ago. I'll show that to you while we're waiting in case you didn't see that. This was my first bloom. I mean, not the greatest, but was my first on a canvas. And I actually painted over the previous bloom that I tried with Kathleen Miller's Wreck-It. I think you do the coverage and then you wreck it. I tried that method. It was horrible. And I made the mistake of letting it dry before instead of just scraping it off. So I sanded it down and cleaned it off real good and painted over it, and that's what I got. So that's a step in the right direction, I think. I'm still learning like everybody else, but I really, really enjoy the bloom and seeing it, you know, come to, you know, all these cells. Like right now, I'm really digging this. I did try the pearl pour. And I think I used the wrong mixture. I think I was missing something. I didn't get any cells, so I scraped that. So when I get the right ingredient, I think I still need one more ingredient, and I'm gonna try that again. So let's give this a spin. Oh, I think this one's gonna be pretty. Ooh, that is pretty. Corners. Maybe I didn't put enough paint on it. But what I was saying before is the things that you learn when you first start. Didn't add the GAC 800 to my pillow paint. So I didn't have like a horrible cracking problem, because I know a lot of people say if you don't add it, you get a lot of cracking. I did have some of my tiles with a little bit of cracking. And I actually got really creative and filled some of them in with glitter. but you really don't even notice it now that I have them coated with Bright Tone. Don't even notice the cracks. But yeah, really, really nice. I love those colors. And I will pull that off and bring it up closer so you guys can see that. I am digging that black background. That was almost completely ruined that. All right, let's see if I can do this without dropping it. Okay, let me get the paint off the bottom here. All right, let's see if I can get this up close enough for you guys to see. How pretty is that? I love it. Love, love, love those colors. All right, I'm gonna try to repeat that. But I am gonna end the video, because I don't want you guys to get bored, and I don't like to keep my videos really long, and I'm approaching 30 minutes. So I like to keep my instructional stuff on the tiles and stuff really short, but these blooms are going to take a while. So I know their videos will have to be longer, but I did want to give you that tip, and maybe this is something you guys already do. I don't know, but I want to show you. If you're going to do tiles, I have found the best thing to set them on are these. And I have like 6 or 7 of these that I got at Goodwill for anywhere from $1 to $2 each. And these are the best things to set your tiles on these grates. I put plastic underneath, like a drop cloth or a garbage bag or something, and I set all my racks on the garbage bag, and I put my finished tiles on here, and that way they drip underneath and they dry, I think, a lot faster and just a lot easier to get off once they are dry. But yeah, super, super easy to use. So just a little tip from Christina on doing tiles. I also, if I do small canvases, I also put those on these. If I do larger stuff, I put them on, and I'll show you, I'll bring you over here and show you how I do this, just for anybody that needs any ideas. Okay, don't get dizzy as I move the camera. So here's the one I did earlier. I don't know if you can get it turned so you can see that. That's on a 15-inch wood circle. So I had this wood in the garage. They're just like 5-foot pieces of, I think, they're just 1 inch wide. And as you can see, there's plastic underneath. And I just, there's my racks. I just set them on there. And if it's a canvas and I want it to dry real slow, I'll put a tub over the top of it. So it gets air from underneath, but it dries a lot slower. So that's my video for today. Stay tuned. I have a lot more planned this week, for some other tile prep. We'll get those up later this week. All right. Thanks.